First opened in 2002, there's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup on tap, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Detroit Lions. The first game's out of the way. Time to buckle down for the long season ahead, and we're off in week two. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. And they start things off with a carry by Gibbs here. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down. Opening quarter, his opening carry of the game, and I think they'll give it to him a few more times, as they should.
You're exactly right about that. With that type of a run, you want to repeat it many times until they show signs of stopping it. I think he did his visualization exercise before this one, and they're paying off.
On first down, it's gone. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe. The Lions at 1-0 on the year following the win in week 1. And they were able to get that road victory in the opener. Now they look to get to 2-0 in front of the home crowd.
And look, any road win in the NFL, that's huge. But when you do it week 1, that gets you pointed in the right direction and sends notice to the rest of the league that you mean business.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 28. A good pickup there at 22.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Goff. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Sets him up nicely. First and goal. It was a pickup of 14.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical. They've been crisp. And as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
They'll run with Gibbs. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Again, it's Gibbs. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Jahmyr Gibbs, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Lions put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
Like what we saw right there, good running down near the goal line, because that was a really good drive. They were able to possess the ball, have some early success moving it downfield, and then clearly the most important thing, finishing things off with the ball in the end zone.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Quarterback 6 times for sacks, and plenty of other turbulence in the pocket for him as well. Hard to throw the ball downfield when all you're seeing is opposing jerseys come at you.
Over the middle, he finds Higgins. So the completion good for seven there. And now third down and six to go. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. This seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
Second and five. Off the play fake, Young. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. You talk about this Lions defense. They were very strong in that victory from a week ago.
And it was the pass rush that really keyed their victory. Got to the quarterback six times for sacks and plenty of other turbulence in the pocket for him as well.
Young to throw it. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that fall incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot.
Here we go.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Now a give to Gibbs, running left. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards, but also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Setting up the screen, this is Gibbs. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Now a second and 10. Goff now to throw. Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Jackrabbit.
A first down carry for Barkley. What a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. To throw, Young. And this is going to be incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Short throw caught by the tight end, Oliver. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
He's unable to use his size to break down much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Young will set to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hook, and they'll say it's incomplete.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Patterson's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
From the 20, here's a 2nd and 8. Now gone. He gets this out wide to Gibbs. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 10 for the Lions and a first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
This is caught by Williams. His first catch, good for 8 and a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. On 1st and 10, here's Gibbs. And he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
On 2nd down, here's Goff. He's got it to Williams. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that will bring up 3rd and 1.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
This will be play number 7 on the drive, 3rd and 1 yard. Gibbs will try and pick it up. And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37.
55 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
After the run, Goff gonna throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Here's second and 10. Straight ahead with Gibbs here. Excellent job of finding the opening as he's got this now all the way down to the 22. 15 yards for the Lions there on a first down.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium, because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Working with the lead, trying to get to 2-0. Here's first and 10. Goff now looking to throw. This will be incomplete. Oh, a dream chance for a D lineman, but he couldn't pull that one in.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Second and 10. Out of the gun, Goff. Over the middle and complete to Waddle. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Here now, third and a yard. They'll run it. Here's Montgomery. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Gibbs is not going to get in here as they push him back to the 2-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. They'll try to run with Gibbs, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Jahmyr Gibbs, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Lions will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Elliott Good with a PAT, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a second and one forthcoming.
Matt Red. Steel Black. Bill Green. Cut.
Young. Finds his man. There's Jordan Addison. And they rally quickly defensively after the grab, but he gets it to the 42. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Glenn, getting set for quarter number 3 here. Ready for the second half. 14-3 our score as we are back underway on EA Sports. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
Ready,
the Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and they'll be left with 2nd and a couple.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And now a hook up downfield on 2nd down. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one covers 29 yards. 1st down.
Double 38. Strike.
Up the middle with Barkley. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again. 2nd and 10. Now here's Young. Complete to Addison on the out route. And it's going to be another 1st down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 27-yard line. Just his 2nd catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Still in search of their 1st touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. 1st and 10. On play action, Young steps away to his left. And he's going to go out of bounds. Gigantic loss. Kept retreating. Steps out. That goes down as a sack and a big loss of yardage.
So when the defense complains about having to do pursuit drills in the heat of training camp, plug in this play. Excellent pursuit. Force the quarterback out of the pocket. He ends up trying to run for it. Instead, he goes out of bounds and loses yardage. That goes down as a sack for the defense.
And that's going to be caught. T. Higgins. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. From the shotgun, it's Young. He gets it to Addison. And he will have a Vikings 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that they're very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
And Young's throw there incomplete.
His impatience has to be bubbling over, trying to find a way to get his team to the end zone for the first time. He did find a way to break contain and get outside to buy his receivers a little extra time, but the connection couldn't be made on that throw.
Black open.
Here's Young. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Jack Campbell with a pick.
Spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out, and as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead is up to 18 now. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Vikings now to start their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Right.
Young to throw it. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
That throw by Young incomplete.
Looks like another empty possession offensively, and you're at that point in the game where you can't afford too many more of these. So this is going to require some heavy thinking on the sideline to figure out what they can do to crack this defense.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
Red cycle. Six. Mega. Broad red.
They'll try and throw for it here. That's going to be brought in by Higgins. And he is going to pick up the Vikings' first down, and they come up with a big one there to keep the drive moving and then some.
I'll tell you what, this is not for the faint of heart right here. Fourth down, this is taking a big risk, but it's as good a play call as you can imagine. And the defense, just not able to come up with the stop they needed. And this is not just a first down, but a big play as well.
Hey, catch Mega.
Barkley inside handoff. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. Another modest gain there on that one. And I think, Charles, you can probably pin part of the deficit on a failure on their part to really get this ground game established.
Yeah, and they've really struggled to be multidimensional in this one, having a partner, because they have to be extremely one-dimensional now if they hope to get back into this game. They'll have to do it by throwing the football and hope to have success through the air. Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense, because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point, and what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue, not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
And Young's throw there incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
To throw on second down is Young. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 32-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. Well, if there was any thought that this thing might turn around for this offense in the second half, I think those thoughts pretty well dashed after that interception return there.
It just has not been a good outing for this unit whatsoever. There's no other way to say it. They've been overmatched, haven't performed to the level that they've needed, and that throw there just going to contribute to this game getting out of hand.
Elliott on for the extra point. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline because he certainly wants him to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Vikings. Saquon Barkley, 63 yards. And the Vikings are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And the lead is down to 28-10. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Lions are able to cover this one up. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
85 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. This offense really looking polished these first couple of weeks. Here's first and 10. They'll go again with Gibbs. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they can let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Third down, now even tougher. Third and 13 after that loss of a yard.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team, both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? Are the legs still there? This has been a tough game. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away.
Let's go now.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their defense was able to force the punt a moment ago, but that's really the first of about eight steps that need to go right for them to get back in this as they start here first and 10. Now Young gets this out to Saquon Barkley. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two. Those short little routes probably going to be open. The defense, they'll let those happen, especially when they can make an inbounds tackle.
Yeah, where's Coach Madden when you need him? He always talked about taking what the defense gives you, but sometimes you have to know when you have to take more. That was one of those situations.
On second down, here's Barkley. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. A first down throw for Young. Forced out to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
On second down, Young. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. Addison will go in motion left. Young on third down. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
Okay, right.
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45.
Hey, it's green. Black Ultra. Dito Blue. Blue Striker.
It'll be Young again. That'll be taken in by Shahid. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That's good for 28 yards.
Down. Mike White.
So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score.
Let's go. Rams, cycle. Ready?
Young on first down. This one caught. It's the tight end, Hockenson. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. Out of the gun, it's Young. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And he'll take this across midfield and inside.